Hello all. In this tutorial, we are going to learn about handling weights in the project, how to handle the weights in the project. We are going to cover why do we need weights in project, different ways of handling weights in Catalan Studio, that is setting up weight in project, use weight keywords in the project, setting up and using weights through manual and script mode in project. Why do we need weights in project? Most of the web applications are developed using Ajax and JavaScript. When a page is loaded by the browser, the elements which we want to interact with may load at different time intervals. If the element is not found or not visible or clickable, then it will throw an exception. Using weights, we can resolve this problem. Let's see how to handle the weights in Catalan. To set up weights at project level, we have to go to Projects Settings menu. And here in the execution, you will find the details of weight. So here, if you see default execution, which browser you want for default execution, you have to select here. Default smart weight. Smart weight feature is introduced in version 7 of Catalan Studio. It tells the web driver to wait for the page to become stable before any operation is performed. And this smart weight feature is available for Chrome and Firefox browsers only. So to enable this, we have to select the enable. And default wait for element timeout is 30 seconds. You can change it to any number of seconds as per your requirement. It enables the execution to wait till the page is loaded and stable. It may take 5 seconds, 2 seconds, 20 seconds. We can set maximum wait time here. We have set it as 30 seconds. So smart wait will enable the execution to wait maximum till 30 seconds in our case. As I said, it is dynamic. Once page is stable, it will resume the action or next execution step and will not wait for 30 seconds to complete. So smart wait enables to wait the application or the execution till the next page is loaded and the next action is ready to perform, and then it performs the action on the next element. Then down here, delay between actions in seconds is set as 0. This is one of the method to handle the delays in between the actions, two actions. For example, if I added a text in the text box and I am going to click on the button, then between these two actions, how much time it should wait, that I have configured here, that you can configure here. So you can configure as 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 5 seconds according to the speed of the web application you are working on. Default wait time when IE hangs. This is for Internet Explorer when it hangs, how much default time it should wait to respond back. Default page load timeout. There are two option buttons available here. One is wait until the page is loaded and one is wait for in seconds 6. So if I mention wait for in seconds 6, it will wait for 6 seconds. Even if the page is loaded, it will still wait for 6 seconds. And if we select this option button, wait until the page is loaded, then it will wait till the page is loaded. It may take 2 seconds, 5 seconds, 10 seconds or 20 seconds, whatever. Wait for in seconds option, there is one checkbox, continue to run after timeout. If this time is over but still the page is not loaded, then it will continue to run after timeout. And if the page is not loaded, the test will fail obviously. So we will select wait until the page is loaded. This option is the best to choose. Apply and OK. This is the way how we set up the weights at project level. Now let's see how to use weight keywords to overcome the issue the object not found or object is not visible or it is not clickable. So how to use it? I have this test case having the login test steps. Here I have clicked on make appointment button, then entered the username and then entered the password, clicked on login button and closed the browser. So in between these two actions, I can add keywords like wait. If you write web UI dot wait, you will get complete list of wait keywords. So here some of the keywords: wait for alert, wait for clickable, or wait for element not clickable, or wait for element visible, wait for element present or not present or not visible. Even you get the keyword to wait for page to load. So for now we will see the wait for element visible. We will take this. Now I have taken it with failure handling step. You can use failure handling or you may remove it. So I will check whether this object is visible and ready to use or ready to perform action on. So I have taken this object and I am passing the time in seconds. So 10 seconds, it will check in these 10 seconds for the object to be visible and then it will click on the object or it will perform the next action on the object. If it does not find the element or the element is not visible within these 10 seconds, then it will handle it by failure handling method which we have given to stop the test on failure. This way you can add the keywords. If you want to add wait for page load, you can add it web UI dot wait for page load and you can give time in seconds. So it will wait for 10 seconds to load the page and then once the page is loaded, the next action will be performed. It will wait for 10 seconds means it will not wait for completion of 10 seconds. The page may display in 2 seconds or 5 seconds, so it will jump to the next step. So it will not wait till this 10 seconds to get over. In manual mode also, you can add your keyword anywhere in between by just clicking add and web UI and selecting here the web UI keywords for wait. So these are the wait keywords. You can choose one of them, which one you want, and you can work on it like element present. So wait for element present. Which element? So select the element name, which element you want to be checked. So I want to check the password and the seconds, how many seconds you want to wait for. This was about handling waits in manual and script mode. And this is the way we handle the wait at project level and at code level. If you are new to this channel and would like to learn Catalan Studio from beginning to advanced, then please click subscribe and bell icon below this video.